Today, I want to talk through 16 things that Sony got right with their A7 S3. This camera is pretty awesome. First up, the viewfinder. This thing is like looking through an optical viewfinder, super high resolution, super high quality. Number two, the new viewfinder detector. They moved the position from up here to down here, and now it's much more effective at detecting whether you're looking through the eyepiece or looking through the monitor. Number three, I'm sure you're aware, the flip screen. It allows you to see yourself when you're filming yourself or shoot from awkward positions like up above or way down below at the ground level. Number four, the menu system. Totally reorganized. It's now touch compatible, touch scroll, very efficient to find what you're looking for. If you want more details, I did a deep dive into what I think is important in setting up your A7S III, so check that video here. Number five, the grip and the custom buttons. Sony's always been really good about custom buttons. Now they've moved the record button right where C1 used to be. C1 is now on the back. So they've changed things around and now it's really compatible and user-friendly. Number six, as I'm sure you've heard, low light capability. This camera is amazing. It's so cool that you can shoot video of things like the stars or extremely dark situations. If you want to see more about that here, check out this video. Number seven, I love that they put a click lock on the exposure compensation dial. This thing no longer gets moved to -3 or +3. It stays right where it's at. Number eight, the lock on the mode dial. Now you don't get bumped around when you're throwing your camera in your bag. Wherever you leave it, that's where it stays. Number nine, they now offer three custom settings, which is awesome for filmmaking. You can have 24p, 60p, and 120p, all now at 4K. Setting up these custom buttons with all the pre-programmed settings that you like allows you to quickly switch modes and have those things pre-programmed so you're never diving into the menu systems. You can just quickly switch one, two, or three. Number 10, 422 10-bit color. Just gives you more latitude in editing and allows you to adjust your exposure and color. And having that will allow your editing workflow to be much easier. Number 11, the strap mounts don't jingle. These are a little more fitted than they used to be, and they no longer make noise when you're bouncing around with the camera. Number 12, this multi-selector button. It has an improved feel and it's just more user-friendly. Number 13, this audio port right on the side is now nice and small and tidy, and it even is compatible with the flip screen, so it's not interfering your view on the viewfinder. Number 14, the USB-C charging port. I love that all the devices are moving to USB-C. It allows you to just simplify and have fewer cords. Number 15, movie mode and stills mode now have separate settings. So when you're switching back and forth between movie mode and stills mode, your settings will not change, and whatever settings you had in photo mode will remain, and same thing with video mode. So that allows you to more easily retain that 180-degree shutter rule. If you're cranking up your shutter speed while you're shooting photos, it won't mess with your video. And lastly, number 16, the lock-on autofocus. I think this was first introduced with the Sony A6600, but it's a super handy feature that allows you to touch the back screen and lock onto a subject, even if you're moving the camera around or even if that subject exits the frame and comes back in. It's really effective at maintaining focus. And those are the 16 things that I think Sony got right with the A7S III. If you haven't already seen it, check out this video of my review and where I dive into a little bit more detail. Be sure to subscribe, and if you have any questions, head down to the comments and let me know what I can help with. Thanks for watching.